Okay, so welcome to Yoga with Smiles. And we have yogas on Friday and we have smile tips today, Tuesday, and nice to see all of you all. And as usual, I'm going to start with a story. But there's a difference this time. I am not going to tell the story. I want any of you all to tell me anything that you feel that you have some good, happy incident which you felt you achieved something. Okay, anything. It can be just one line, two lines, whatever. So I want to hear from you. Something in your life which you feel you have achieved. You feel good about yourself. Okay, this is what you did. So come on, who's going to start? Any of you all? Come on, small thing, one line. I know most of you all personally, so many of us today on the call, so nice. So who will start? Think of something that makes you happy, some old incident, you know, something that it can be when you're in school, your college, whenever. I told you it has to be interactive. Only then this program is, otherwise I can just give a lecture on the video. So who's going first? Anyone, only one. I know so many things you all have achieved. Come on. But I want you to say that.
Best husband.
Oh, good. Best husband
best
you
parents,
got. Very good. Okay. Yeah. So, okay. Anybody else? Any one thing? Come on. Just one line is okay. One word is also fine.
Hello?
Yeah, Ushaka, tell me.
I'm a very shy person. Usually I talk with very few people, only people whom I know. But on this 1.5 years, this Zoom online yoga classes, they just called me one day. I said, Akka, you have to take the class, yoga class.
Very
I said,
nice.
No, I'm not going to take. But then said, you know, you should take. So then I just made an attempt and I could teach. So, that really made me very happy.
Yeah. So nice. So nice. You know?
I thought I'll never be able to do such
things. Yeah. Even me and technology, you know, organizing this Zoom call or, you know, sitting and talking
learned
to everybody.
So
we
learn
so many things. So all of us, okay?
Yes.
So let's take this example of Ushaka conducting yoga class, okay? Can you put your videos on? So, I want to ask you one question. Do you think that this achievement was because of your efforts alone? Think of any achievement that you have. Think. Do you think this achievement that you got, do you think it's because of you alone? Or are there some people who are responsible for your achievement? Who do you think is responsible for any achievement that you got? This is a question for everybody.
Other people are responsible.
Definitely, it's not. You cannot say that I did it alone, isn't it? Most of the achievements that we have, there is a lot of other people who are responsible for that. Okay? To name a few, your parents who gave you birth. This should not even be here to do that. Your, you know, friends who have motivated you. The teacher who taught you the yoga, you know, the people who taught you the technology to organize a Zoom class, organize that yoga class. Okay? Think of some more people who are responsible for that success of yours.
Yeah, the ones who were with me, they used to encourage me.
Correct.
Akka, you can do it.
Yes.
They used to tell me, my husband also, he always used to tell me, why
Correct.
Are you scared? You can do it.
Correct.
Then everybody.
Yeah. So.
My children.
Yes.
With whom I used to go. Everybody. They all said, yes, you can do it.
Correct.
Now so otherwise, I think it would have been possible.
So the teacher who taught you yoga, his teacher's teacher, whoever taught him yoga, you know, the mat that you're sitting on, this yoga mat that we have, you know, the one who has invented this.
Yes.
You know, the thing, now I want you to, you know, broaden your perception of people who are responsible for your success today. Okay? Think of the maid servant who sits and cleans his floor so that you can sit on a good mat. Isn't she important? Think of the driver or who drove you to that yoga class where you learned the yoga. Think of the security man who stood outside and guarded the place so that you could peacefully do your yoga without any tension. So I want you to think about that for any, see, you know, most of the time how we have been conditioned is that I want to do this, I want to be first, I want to be the leader, I want to be the best. But remember one thing, I can never do anything all alone. It is always a we. It is because there is a team of people who either knowingly or unknowingly, directly or indirectly, they have contributed to your success, to your achievement, which you say, oh, today I did this. Okay, so that is going to be our topic today. Our topic today is about the team of people that we have around us and the relationship that we have with them. Okay, so first of all, I want you to acknowledge that there is a whole lot of people behind you for what you are today. We forget it, you know, most of the time we think that I did this, I did that. No. And I want you to expand your thinking, okay, that you have a huge team of people who are responsible for your success. Yes or no? For wherever you are today. Now I want you to, if you can, sit. These are the team of people who will help you to make this life have a better quality of living. We all know rich and poor, and we associate rich and poor with money. But, you know, we all want to spend our whole life trying to improve our net worth. We want to show big balances, big assets, and big all sorts of materialistic things. But I want you to change your perception. Okay, your net worth doesn't matter right now. COVID has taught us that. But what really matters is your net worth. How many of y'all have the ability? What is networking? You know what is networking? Networking is just having a social circle. You know, personal circle, family circle, relative circle, social circle, community circle. Like I say, it does not matter what house or what you live in or what car you drive. What matters is who's sitting in the house with you. Who's sitting in the car next to you. That is what matters. That is what is going to affect the quality of your life. I always say the quality of your life is the quality of your relationships. Correct? The richer relationships you have, the more rich your life is. Think about it. What really gives us, you know, moments of remembrance are moments that we have spent with people. That is what we remember, not what things we have, because you know, things that come, things that go. But these moments that we have spent with the people with whom we have had rich relationships, that is what matters ultimately in the long run. Okay? So, we have gone through different. Okay, now I want you to think about who are the people that if you have an issue and at 3 o'clock in the morning you want to talk to them, who are the people that you can pick up the phone and talk to? If you can, make a list of those people. You can just pick up the phone at 3 o'clock in the morning and say, look here, I want to talk to you. They are your team members. They are your core team members. Similarly, you have to ask yourself, are you also a team member for somebody else's life? Why will they do anything for you at 3 o'clock in the morning? Because they know that you also will do anything for them at 3 o'clock in the morning. Correct? Like, it's like you have to give and that's how you get in your relationships. Givers get. That is a rule throughout life. So ask yourself, at how many teams are you a member of? Okay? And is it easy being a team member? So basically, there are four stages in become. And when I talk of team, you know, I'm not talking about cricket team or hockey team. I'm talking about the teams that you have in your life. Okay, what are the difference between teams and a group of people? We keep going attending social functions. We keep having groups everywhere. Okay. What are the difference between teams and groups? Any idea? Why do you call some people as just group members and some people as your team members? Are we a team or are we a group of people? We. Think about it. Your video is off. I mean, audio is off. Put your audio on. Huh? Are we a team or are we a group? The difference between a group and a team. Yeah, Malika, you're saying something?
We are a group because we don't know everybody.
Correct.
I mean, you know, I don't know everybody in the group.
Yeah.
So we are a group. Hmm. Maybe with you, it's a team.
Correct.
Because I know.
Very, you put it across very nicely. Yeah. So the difference is between when you're a group, you're just different people coming together. But when you're a team, you are both committed to the same cause. You have a common objective. So we have a common objective of physical fitness and mental fitness. And it is that common objective that makes us become a team. If there is no common objective, so in a way, since all of us, if we are committed, that is why this program is open to everybody. But people who are really committed to their physical fitness and mental fitness, they are the ones who will come again and again. Okay, so you need a common objective if you have to be a part of a team member for somebody. Okay, so in the team, when you are a team member, there are four stages before you become a team member. So the first is you form a team. Okay, all of us are forming a team. So that means you come together for one common objective. So next stage is norming. So in the norming stage, there is a common objective. And then each person is assigned one responsibility. You name people. So one person does this, second person does this, third person does this. That's called norming stage. Okay? And everybody is working towards that common goal. The third stage is called storming stage. Because obviously you and I have come with different mindsets. I have some strong view about something. You have some strong view about something. If I have a right to express my view, you also have a right to express your view. And then they find that most of the teams that try to come together, they will obviously have difference of opinion, and that's why it's like a storm. Okay? And we have to go through this storming stage with everyone. Very, very rare you'll find someone who matches you perfectly in your mindset and your thinking. Even the husband-wife team, they have gone through lots of storms together. Okay? He may be the best husband or the best children, but we have gone through all the storms. Parent and child also. And after you go through the storming stage, what happens in the storming stage? You encounter a lot of heartaches. Okay? And so you encounter a lot of heart pain, a lot of grief, a lot of sadness, a lot of emotions. So there will be up and down, both emotions. Okay, but if it's the storming stage, then you get angry, irritated, upset, frustrated, sad, okay, about your relationships. And where do you store all that? In your heart. Every corner of the heart, something that happened in 1978, it is still stored in somewhere in the corner. All your emotions. And that is when your heart chakra gets blocked. So there is a combination, there is a connection between the soft skills term of teamwork or interpersonal relationships and the heart chakra. And when you keep accumulating, every day you have different experiences. Some experiences give you high emotions, but many experiences do not give you kind of a very strong emotions in your heart. And this actually manifests in kind of heart issues. You have asthma problem or heart problem or breathing problem. All that happens with this heart chakra. So if you go through what somebody wants in life, okay, or even the chakras have been put in a ascending order. So we did the first chakra, your base chakra, which was about materialism, feeling secure. That's what man wants, isn't it? Feeling. So that was connected, grounded to the earth. Then we did, above that, it was the emotional chakra, okay, which was connected. That's the next thing what a person wants, okay. He has certain desires, he wants to fulfill them. The universe balances or fulfills them. That is the second water-based second chakra, sacral chakra. Then next, what after you got your basic needs, you got your desires fulfilled, next what man looks for? Some kind of power, you know, power over yourself, power over other people, whatever changing circumstances, you want to have the power. And most of the people live like that. They are born, they accumulate materialism, fulfill desires, want power, and then they die. This is the three base chakras. That's why these lower, they are called the lower chakras or the base chakras. Okay? And from here and above is the upper, higher chakras. But the heart chakra, I feel, is one of the most important chakra that you need to pay attention, because it's called the bridge chakra. It bridges between the lower chakras and the higher chakras. And there is only one answer to all the relationship issues that you have. And that answer is love. So can somebody define love for me? I know all of you all are married and all of you all have been in love one time or the other. So can someone define what is love? At least the first thing that comes up, define, but whatever you think, what is love?
Unconditional,
yes. You know, we don't love somebody because he's like that, she's like that, he did this, he did that, he supports me. No, that is not love. Love, I will, if I put it in one word, I will say love is not for, or love is not because, love is in spite of. So in spite of all the irritating things that the person does, in spite of all the horrible things that the person says, in spite of the worst possible behavior that somebody can behave with you, if you can still get yourself to love somebody, that is love. And most of the time we are very conjuice in our love, you know, very miserly in our love. We will love our family, we will love our friends, we will love our social circle. And we think love is very limited. I remember, you know, in 1989, my mother-in-law was in hospital and I was staying 3 weeks in the hospital. And in the next room, there was a nun, a sister, who was admitted, and there was another sister who was looking after her. And I had no, since I was staying in the hospital, whole day I had no work, I would just sit and talk with her. And that's the first time I experienced that you can love just for no reason. You can love anybody and you can love humanity. You know, when that lady, when that sister was talking to me about somebody she met when she was crossing the road, one small boy, and then she spoke to him and she did that. No, I could genuinely feel so much of love she had for that small stranger that she met for probably 5 minutes when crossing the road. So can we expand our love that we have and go beyond our, it's natural, all of us love our family and we love our thing. Can we expand it and can we feel this love for humanity as such? You know, you, and this is how this love is expressed, is by this term called kindness, compassion, feeling what other people are feeling. So love is not, is you don't have to, you can't define love. I can't say do this or do that, but love is expressed in your behavior. So tell me, if you go in a rickshaw, okay, and you have an argument with the rickshaw driver, and the rickshaw driver says something really bad to you, okay, how long will you be upset? Probably just few minutes, okay, till you go and reach your place. But then you forget about the rickshaw driver. You know? So, how come a rickshaw driver who has spoken harsh words to you does not affect you? But how come we get so affected when the people that we love behave in a different way to us? Because we are committed. Here our love is matching the commitment that we have to them, isn't it? So one of the greatest challenges in relationships is maintaining the relationships with people that you love. And that is why you have to keep reminding yourself that yes, I love this person in spite of this behavior. And one of the aspects, and you have to keep opening, okay, the more you feel love inside, the bigger your heart chakra becomes. You know, there is a song which I just heard today. It was so funny that after all, you know, in school, I don't know if Debbie remembers, we had this singer from our school, Preeti Sagar, and she sang this song, "My heart is beating, keeps on repeating." Remember that song? "I'm waiting for you. My love encloses a plot of roses. And when shall be then our next meeting. 'Cause love, you know, that time is fleeting, time is fleeting, time is fleeting. You know, it was just a popular English song in a Hindi movie those days. But today it was such a coincidence that I heard it just now. Something I was browsing and I heard that song. And I was thinking, what a fantastic message. Do we realize time is fleeting? We are all on towards the end of our lives, most of us. Time is really fleeting. Every moment you have with people is precious. So can we just forgive them for whatever they are? And see, sometimes things are there which you cannot forget. But you need to practice this forgiveness in your head. Not for their sake, but for your sake. Because minute you forgive people in your head, see, when you sleep and you get up in the morning, and if you're thinking of somebody, the first thing when you get up in the morning or the last thing before you go to sleep, then either it is about a person that you love very much, or it's about a person who is troubling you very much. Okay? And if you are going to get upset about it again and again, it's only you who are having the trouble. So if you can just say that, yes, I love you, however you are, I love you. Just say it in your mind. I forgive you. I love you. You will be surprised when you are filled with love, then the world is, you will attract loving people. Okay, so that's very important in your heart chakra. It's very, very important that, you know, you have to keep getting this love again and again. And how we women are, most of the time we think love is only to be given. We are very expert in giving love to the whole world. What about receiving love? Are we gracious enough to receive love? Somebody gives you a compliment and says, you know, you're looking nice. Oh, today I just, no, it's nothing. We don't even know how to receive compliments. So you have to practice both giving love and become aware when people are loving you. And be gracious in accepting love also. And I've told this before also. Who is your harshest critic in this world? Tell me. Don't tell me, but think about it.
Ourselves.
You, sir. Ourselves. Yes. Who said that? Yeah.
Me.
Yeah.
Ourselves.
So we, you know, the reason we criticize ourselves so much is, okay, sometimes my behavior was bad. Sometimes I said things I should not have said. I thought things that I should not have said. I should not have thought. I said things I should not have said. I did things which I should not have done. So what? How long are you going to beat yourself for it? Can you just, you know, all of us, before coming here, I went in front of the mirror. I combed my hair. I put one dress. I checked all my, how is this thing? Why do you spend so much of time in front of the mirror? Because you want to impress somebody wherever you are going out. Next time you are in front of the mirror, I want you to stop 1 second and look at the person on the other side of the mirror. Look at the person in the eyes. Spend some time and just stop trying to impress the world. The world is not going to get impressed by you. Not all of them are going to get impressed all the time. What is more important is check whether are you impressed with that person on the other side of the mirror, however that person is. Everybody lift your right hand. Come on, everybody, lift your right hand. All of you all, think you're standing in front of the mirror. Lift your left hand. Lift your left hand. Left hand also, both of you all. Both the hands. Think you're standing in front of the mirror. Put your right hand on your left shoulder. left hand on your right shoulder. Think you're looking at the mirror and think, look at your image on the screen and say, I love you. Come on, let me hear you saying that.
I
really, really love you.
I
really love you. I really, really love you. Because you're looking at your own photo on the screen and saying that. Okay? You know, we are so attached. When my parents died, I thought my world had come crashing down. It was a void which is natural. I think till today that void is not gone. It was so bad. You know, I thought I'm all alone in this world. And then remember something, you are never alone. As long as you love yourself. You have that person in the mirror who is always with you. And when you start have that self-love, you know, it shows. When you go out, it shows. People can see a loving person out in this world. And it doesn't matter when you go, so many places I go, I don't know anybody. I'm all alone. But I'm very happy with myself. I sit and I do observing. I observe what's happening. Okay? So, love starts with self-love. Okay? So, it's about loving yourself first. It's only when you have enough of love, then you can give love to the world. Okay, so I had a friend who was my age, 52, 53, this is about 5 years back. And everybody, she was a single mother, and everybody told her when her daughter got married, please, why don't you look out for somebody? You need someone to look after you. You know, why don't you get married again? And on Valentine's Day, she went up on stage and she put her hand up and she says, you know, in Hindi, you can understand Hindi, all of you all? She said, everybody told me that I should find love, you know, because I need someone to love me. But today, I am filled with so much of love. So much of love that I want somebody to give my love. And what a difference. The way she said in Hindi, she said, Hai koi maa ka laal is duniya mein jo mera haath tamne ke liye tayyar hai. And we laughed and we said, and she really said it with super. Valentine's Day, we were all in the class, we were sitting, and you know, this is a class which I do. I do a lot of programs to become a trainer, so I attend a lot of programs. And there's a class about love and Valentine's Day. You won't believe, within 1 week on the website, somebody contacted her. This was February 14th, she said that. May, she got engaged. June 2nd, on my wedding anniversary day, she got married. At 55 years. At 53 years, I think that time she was. Yeah. You know, and today she's 7 years married, happily married she is today. So that is the power of love. Okay, I can give 100 examples with my own son. Okay, whatever I had, something, you know, during his wedding time, it was going on. And one day I just told whole night I sang one song, I love you, I love you, I love you. And the minute I was full of love, suddenly out of the blue, he turns back and he says, Ma, I love you, I always have, I always will. It was such a shock for me. I went running from Dubai and went to meet him. Next day, second day later, I was on the flight to India to talk about his marriage and talk and make his wedding preparations. That is the power of love. So see whether you can make love as your part of your. And so the color associated with the heart chakra, love, is green. The element of, like you said, earth, water, fire, and this element is air. Okay, air is the element for love. So fresh air, nature, that manages. Then there are any exercise which expands your heart. Okay, I'm not dressed.